upon the mountain, we found a little cave. Me and my good buddy, old one-arm fishing Dave. Dave said to me, let's go in there. I said, hell no, Dave, there might be a grizzly bear. And he said, you know those bears all hibernate in the winter. And I said, I don't mean he won't get up and make you for your dinner. Hell, he eat your other arm, how you gonna fish? Well, Dave wouldn't listen, he went on inside. I heard a loud scream, then Dave come running by. I said, you cannot run that bear, Dave, what the hell are you trying to do? He said, I don't have to outrun this bear, just gotta outrun you. Outrun me? Ain't a one-armed little man in this world's gonna outrun me. I throwed down my pole and I started to run. And with the bear close behind, I was wishing I had a gun. Dave's way ahead and the bear's gaining fast. Didn't know that one little guy could run that goddamn fast. And as I tripped Dave, I could plainly see the envy in his eyes as I climbed up the tree. I smiled down at Dave at the bottom of the tree. And then he hooked a squirrel-tailed maps in me. It hit me in the zipper and he tugged on the line. By the time I hit the ground, I could see us way behind. Dragging a fishing pole and running with everything I got, the bear grabbed the pole and he brought me to a stop. Ugh. Damn, Dave, 20-pound test for 6-inch brookies. I dug in my pocket for my Swiss Army knife. Finally got a blade on a very third try. Cut the line, I was running once again. Saw Dave on the edge of a cliff, so I went and stood by him. I looked at Dave and the lake far below, and the bear's closing in, so I guess we better go. God, the water's 20 feet deep or more. I watched Dave swim in circles as I climbed up on shore. Trudged back down the trail and got an international scout. I threw the winch line in, I dragged Dave out. We dumped out Dave's waders, and to our surprise, a 6-pound rainbow, and the others ain't bad sized.